The last topic that I wanted to cover in the Introduction to Microeconomics series is the context of economics as a social science and as a policy tool. When we study the social sciences, we have two aspects to an argument. Firstly, we look at cold, hard facts. When we give out a statistic to support our claims, for example, we are making what is known as a positive statement. If I tell you that GDP increased by 6%, I am making a positive statement. A normative statement is one which deals with our own beliefs and values. If I say that the unemployment rate should be lowered, I would be making a normative statement. I'm expressing my own beliefs about what ought to be. To answer cause and effect questions in economics, we use economic models. A model is a description of some aspect of the economy that includes only those variables that are needed to assess what we are looking at. Essentially, we assume that nothing else in the economy changes except what we are looking at. This is known as the ceteris paribus assumption. For example, if we ask what happens to the quantity demanded of a good when its price changes, we are assuming that the prices of other goods in the market, income, taxes, etc., remain the same. We only care about what price does to the quantity demanded of a good. If you have no idea about the supply and demand model, don't worry, we'll cover that in a future lecture. For now, just know that when we perform economic analysis, we assume that all other aspects of the world remain the exact same. When economists advise the government on policies that should be implemented, there is a lot that goes into it. It's a very complicated process. Put very simply, the economist tries to figure out what the best use of the resources in the economy is. He or she does so by comparing the marginal costs, or the additional cost of producing an additional unit of a good, to the marginal benefits, or additional benefits gained from consuming an additional unit of a good. As a general rule of thumb, when the marginal cost is equal to the marginal benefit, we have reached a point that we can say is making the best use of resources. That was a lecture on an introduction to microeconomics.